Belinda Audio presents this recording of What Bumosaur Is That? Written by Andy Griffiths and read by Stig Weems. Introduction. Life on Earth began with primitive bumteria that appeared in the oceans during the Pre-Crappian era, 600 million years ago. Over time, these bumteria bumvolved into more complex forms of bum life, including invertebrates, bumfish, bumphibians, stenchtiles, phatropods, stinksects, and bumornithids, until eventually giving rise to the group of stenchtiles we know as the bumosaurs. Bumosaurs appeared on the Earth 203 million years ago, at the beginning of the Triassic period. They came in a stunning variety of shapes and sizes, with an equally stunning variety of stinks and stenches. Dominating bum life on Earth for the next 150 million years, bumosaurs disappeared from the fossil record around 65 million years ago. The extinction of the bumosaurs allowed a new species of bum life called bumels to bumvolve, eventually leading to the emergence of the earliest bum men. Although the focus of this book is on bumosaurs, examples of bum-related life forms from all major groups have been included in order to provide the most comprehensive and up-to-date guide to prehistoric bum life ever published. Invertebrates. Life on Earth began in the seas with primitive bumteria during the Pre-Crappian era. Over time, these early single-cheeked bums clumped together to form some of the first multi-cheeked invertebrates in the Crapozoic era oceans. Bum sponge, trilobut, jelly bumfish, sea scorpibum, spiny bum urchin, octobumopus. Bum sponge. The bum sponge lived permanently attached to the sea floor, absorbing bumteria. It had two distinct cheeks, which is the identifying characteristic of all forms of bum life, both modern and prehistoric. What it lacked, however, were arms, legs, a mouth, internal organs, a nervous system, a personality, and hobbies or interests of any kind. It is believed that the species was forced to bumvolve other features, such as the ability to create bubbles by releasing gas underwater in an effort to entertain itself and relieve the boredom of its incredibly dull life. Vital statistics. Scientific name, Squeezius cheeky. Family, Squishabut. Diet, Bumteria ivorans. Time, Crappian, 540 to 500 MYA, million years ago. Stink rating, 1. Trilobut. Appearing some 600 million years ago, the trilobut was a hard, triple-cheeked bottom feeder. Its flattened shape made it uniquely suited to filtering mud, invertebrate droppings, and bumganic particles as it scuttled along the sea floor. Its hard shell kept it safe from predators, thus it was one of the most successful of all early bum life forms. It swam, crawled, and burrowed in the Crapozoic oceans for the next 350 million years. There were many different species of trilobut, and some, such as the Trilobutus gigantus, grew to enormous proportions. Vital statistics. Scientific name, Trichechium buttus. Family, Stinkabut. Diet, Mud ivorans. Time, Crapozoic era, 540 to 250 MYA. Stink rating, 2. Jelly bumfish. Despite having no bones, no heart, no blood, and no brains, the gas-filled bum-cheek-shaped jelly bumfish was one of the fiercest of the later soft-bodied invertebrates. Jelly bumfish travelled in large schools, trailing their long stenchicles behind them. These stenchicles each had a deadly jelly bum on the end, which could swiftly kill captured prey by infecting them with deadly bumteria. The jelly bumfish would then absorb the prey's body by bumosis, a primitive form of osmosis in which food is absorbed through tiny pores in the bum cheeks. Vital statistics. Scientific name, Piscatus jellibulus. Family, Squishabutt. Diet, Carnivore-arse. Time, Ordungosian, 500 to 435 MYA. Stink rating, 1. Sea scorpibum. The sea scorpibum was the giant ancestor of the modern-day scorpion and one of the most feared prehistoric deep-water bum life forms. The enormous claws of a sea scorpibum could cut a giant trilobut in half, and the venom sacs in its bum-shaped stinger contained raw sewage so potent that it could kill a school of jelly bumfish within seconds. Evidence suggests, however, that these terrifying creatures engaged in quite elegant courtship rituals. These would begin with the male grasping the female's pincers and performing a dance called the Bumheaded Adieu. This dance eventually developed into a range of styles, including bum room dancing, bum ballet, stench jazz, and stink hop. Vital statistics. Scientific name, Scorpius oceana. Family, Pincherbutt. Diet, Carnivore-arse. Time, Ordungosian saurian, 500 to 410 MYA. Stink rating, 2. Spiny bum urchin. One of the spikiest and most unpleasant of the unpleasant prehistoric deep water creatures, the spiny bum urchin left behind a trail of death and destruction wherever it went. Although it fed exclusively on other smaller spiny bum urchins, stuffing them two or three at a time into its horrid little spiny mouth, many other creatures were spiked to death on its long spiny spines as it moved across the prehistoric ocean floor in search of more spiny bum urchins to stuff into its horrid little spiny mouth. Vital statistics. Scientific name, Spinius bummy. Family, Cannibalabutt. Diet, spiny bum urchinivorous. Time, Ordungosian, 500 to 435 million years ago. Stink rating, 2. Octobumopus. The eight-armed, eight-headed, 16-cheeked, 16-eyed octobumopus was a predecessor of the eight-armed, one-headed, two-eyed octopus that we are familiar with today. As well as being bizarre in appearance, the octobumopus had a highly developed defence system. If threatened, it would eject eight clouds of thick brownish liquid to blind and disgust predators. It would then use the incredible thrusting power of its 16 cheeks to escape at high speed, leaving its attacker completely grossed out and in desperate need of an industrial-strength disinfectant. Vital statistics. Scientific name, Octavio Posteriossi. Family, Fricasaur. Diet, Carnivore-arse. Time, Saurian.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.